Hello.
Hello, Thomas.
How you doing, mate?
I'm okay. What about you?
Okay. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah. So, what about we talking today?
Education.
Education. It's our profile. Not the profile. How to say? What we do every day.
Yes, what do you want to learn next here?
Okay, I see. So, what is the first question?
Well, what do you want to learn next?
What?
What do you want to learn next?
Next?
Yes.
Hard to say. It's a really hard question. I don't know. Maybe it's a something like language or programming. It's not a language in the meaning. It's like programming language. You know.
Yes, I know programming languages. Yes, I understand. But learn new programming languages, yes. Hello, Mary.
Hello.
How are you doing tonight?
I'm okay, thank you. How are you?
Good, thanks. We're talking about education today. How was your educational experiences?
I have education. I study in university, in school.
You studied what?
In school and in university.
What did you study?
Where?
What?
What?
Yes.
A different subject.
What was your major? Do you have a major?
In university we can't choose a subject.
Okay. What did they have you study? Did you have a special thing you graduated with?
I study physics, math, study chemistry.
Chemistry, yeah.
Chemistry and I forgot. I try to translate quantum mechanic.
Quantum?
Yes.
Like quantum physics? Like that?
Mechanica.
Mechanic.
Yes.
Quantum mechanics? Quantum yes. Mechanics? I think I've heard this term before. So which did you like, Mary? Which of the subjects did you like the most?
I don't know. I don't like chemistry, but everything else I like.
You didn't have a favorite subject?
My favorite, I don't know, in university. You know, in university you don't have favorite subject. You have favorite maybe teacher.
Okay. Did you have a favorite teacher?
I think yes, I won. I have he was very good. He is very good teacher.
What did
Prof
he
sometimes.
teach? What did he teach?
Many subjects, not one, maybe five or
Oh,
four.
really?
Yes, because we have many subjects very close. So sometimes we have one teacher who told about few subjects.
Joke subjects?
Maybe two subjects in one semester.
Oh, I see. What's a popular thing for people to study in university?
Usually, people study Ukrainian language, English language, but I don't know. I think it's not really helpful to study Ukrainian language in university because we studied in school, and after that, if you, it's not your main subject, it's only a waste of time, I think. It's not
Okay.
necessary. And something like ecology and physical activity, sometimes it's not really interesting and not really useful.
Okay. Alexander, can you hear me? Alexander,
Yes.
hello.
Hello. Hello.
How are you doing tonight?
I'm good. Thank you. How are you?
Good, good, good. We're talking about education. Do you have anything special that you do that other people don't know about?
Sorry, could you repeat the question?
Yes, do you have any, can you tell us about any kind of educational experiences that you've had?
New what?
Experiences, like in school, did you enjoy school?
Yes, I finished school.
Well, did you enjoy it? Did you like it or did you hate it?
I liked it at first classes, at first years, and then I became more lazy and I didn't like
You didn't like it.
less.
Did you have a main course of study?
Sorry.
Did you graduate with some kind of a degree?
I finished school and university.
Does it was it useful in your life, your education?
Sorry, I didn't get.
Is it useful in your life to have this education? I mean, are you using this education to make money with this?
No. I think no, it's not so useful for getting money, but maybe it's useful for mind, maybe.
Well, I mean, what did you study that you don't use? I don't understand.
I don't understand too.
What did you study in school? Did you have a main subject matter? Did you graduate with a degree in something?
General objects, geography, biology, math, and other.
Okay, can you tell some experiences you had in school that you really liked?
No,
You
I don't
understand?
remember.
You don't remember.
Yeah.
Okay, Mary, do you have any experiences that you would like to tell us about?
No, I don't
No,
remember anything
you don't remember?
funny about
Okay.
university and
Has it been that long ago?
what?
Has it been that long ago since you were at university?
No, maybe 3 years ago, maybe 4 years ago.
Okay. Well, all right. Did you? Do you think that you got a good education at this school, at the university?
Middle. I don't think I have a good education, but I have normal, not something special. But
Okay.
I remember something I forgot, because maybe I don't use it.
Do you think that the schools had more money that they would give you better education?
If schools have more money?
Yeah. Do you think the
No,
education would be
I
better?
don't think so. No, we have another generation of children, and these children don't want to learn. They want maybe to read something in social network, but don't learn.
Why?
I
Why do
don't
you
know
think?
why, because I have a sister and she learn in school, and I know her friends, and all of them don't know anything.
Really?
Yes, I ask some simple question about biology, math. We speak about something, and they can answer for anything, very simple question, and it's really a terrible situation. And if I learn something very, very simple phrase in English, they also can answer like example, how are you? And they didn't know what it mean. Really.
That's sad, isn't it, do you think?
Yes, it's very, very sad, but they all time in online in some social network, and they all time spend their time for something else, not for study.
Okay. Alexander, did you have a favorite subject in school?
Do I have a favorite subject?
Yes, did you like math or some languages or science, or did you have something favorite?
Maybe physical culture.
Physical culture.
Yes, and
Physical culture. What is this physical culture?
it is a subject. It's like a subject in Russia was. Maybe you don't have so subjects in school, but we have physical.
What is the subject about?
It's like not studying, it's doing physical exercises.
Oh, physical fitness.
Yes, that's cool.
Okay, but that's like a business. I mean, people run workout centers and all this. Exercise is a big money-making business, isn't it?
School, it's obligatory subject we need to do.
Mandatory. Must do this, right? Yeah, I understand. Are you do you still exercise every day?
I try to do, yes.
Try to. Do you
Try.
succeed most of the time? Do you do this or not?
Sometimes I don't have time,
Sometimes
but
you don't.
yes.
Okay. Well, if you get a good education, do you think that it helps you get a good job?
Sorry, could you repeat the question?
Yes. If you get a good education, do you think that helps you get a good job?
Good job. No, still I didn't get a job by education.
Do you think that you've gotten a better education, you've gotten a better job?
I don't know. If maybe yes, if you want to, depends on job what you want. If you want to get job, sometimes you need to have speciality.
Yeah, okay. Do you have a job now?
No, yes,
No?
I have a
You
job.
do?
Yeah.
Do you like it?
Yes.
Good. Good, good, good.
Not very much.
Not very much, but yes.
Yeah.
Okay, Mary, what is some of the things that is the difference between good students and bad students?
I think good students want to learn, but bad students won't do something else.
Why do you think this is natural, or think this is that kind of society makes them that way? Or do you think they're just born that way?
Maybe because students all time, it's some age. And maybe in this age, a lot of things more interesting for people than school and university. That's why they don't want to learn. They want maybe to get fun and do something else.
Well, was you like that when you were that age?
No, I learned. When it was in university and in school.
All the
what?
Maybe sometimes, but I learn. I never been in maybe club and in some other place. I prefer to learn in school and university.
And what is about marks? Do you have only 5 or excellent marks?
In school, I have good marks. But in university, I have maybe sometimes I have not really good situation with my teachers, and sometimes I have not really good mark because I prefer to say true because I disagree with teacher, and it sometimes have not really good. I forgot what. Consequences.
Consequences. Yes. Has bad consequences when you argue with the teacher. Right?
Yes, for me, because I have one teacher who says that all of us very stupid and we should to grow tomato and cucumber, but why we in this place? And I was disagree with him. So I have a bad mark.
Okay.
Good story.
That's a good story. I like the story too. Alexander, did you get good marks in school?
Yes. In some for some subjects, I had good marks. It's like a physical culture, math. And English, yeah.
Did you get along good with your teachers?
Sorry?
Did you get along good with your teachers? Did you argue with your teachers?
Oh, no.
No?
No.
Even if you disagree with them?
It's not useful to argue with teachers.
Did you have any teachers that really impressed you? They were really good teachers?
Yes. Some teachers was good. Some was not.
Well, overall, is your school, is your university, did they have they had good what they call faculty, a lot of good teachers?
No, I didn't get your
long do you, at your university, did they have a lot of good teachers? Many good teachers?
No, usually 50-50. Some of them good, some of them very boring, and it's difficult to study when they're so boring.
Do you think that if they paid more money, they could get better teachers?
I don't think so. I think it doesn't depend on money. If teacher love her job, that teacher would be good, I think.
But I mean, it's true that you know, if you pay more, you can usually get better work out of somebody, right? You get a better job. You hire better. I don't know what. It's better. Somebody fix your house. You pay more money, usually get better work done, right? Isn't that true?
I didn't get. Sorry.
If you pay more, you get a better job, right?
If I pay what for what?
If you need somebody to fix your apartment, fix your flat, you have a problem. Do you think that if you paid more, you'd get a better job done? Or do you think it'd be the same job whether you paid a lot or not, or a little? Do you understand?
No.
No.
Could you ask some easier words?
Ask this. And we
what?
Can understand. Ask this question to Mary.
Okay, Mary.
Yes.
Do you think that if we if you paid the teachers more money, that they you could that school could get better teachers?
Not always. I think sometimes it's this. I forgot what. Sometimes teacher want to be teacher. So and if it's true, and she or he is a good teacher. But sometimes, if you pay or not pay, if it's bad teacher, it is bad teacher, and you can't do anything.
Well, can't they? If they had more money, they could get rid of the bad teachers, get better teachers, right?
I think in this case, you can't fix this with money.
Really? Yes. Why not?
Maybe. Because if it's a really bad teacher, you can't to improve teacher.
Well, you can fire him, can't you? You can fire him?
You can fire teacher.
Yes.
But
why not? What?
But you can't improve teacher.
Maybe yes? You can't improve, but you get a new teacher, right?
Yes, you can find new teacher, but you can pay teacher this money like a previous, and it can be a lot or can be not a lot.
So no matter what you pay, they're going to be what they're going to be, right? Is that what you're saying? Okay. What, Alexander?
Yeah.
What are you going to learn next?
Learn? Next?
Yes, you have something you want to know, something you want to learn, and you're going to go learn this new thing.
I think if I will know English excellent, I would learn French.
Okay, but you're studying English now, right? I mean, so we're doing here now. What's something else you haven't started doing that you would like to do? Do you have something like this in mind? Something new to learn?
I don't know. I don't have time to learn something else, but if I had, I would learn some interesting hobby like taking pictures and other learning other languages.
Photography and languages, okay?
Yes.
Mary, same question to you. What would you like to learn next? Do you have something in mind you want to know?
I don't know. I learn French, English. Learn to paint. I know. I want to learn to draw a car. I can't.
You want to do what? Draw what? Drive a car. Drive a car.
Yes, drive a car.
That's not a good idea.
Because I never tried.
Is it difficult to get your driver's license in your country?
No, not difficult. But I don't know why I don't do it. Maybe I will be a good driver. By luck, Alexandra.
By alarm. Alexander, can you drive?
Yes, I am a driver.
You are? Do you have a car?
I have a car, yes.
Is it fun?
Give us something like an instruction. What
yes.
To do, how to drive.
Yes, tell us how to drive. We don't know. What's good about driving?
What's good?
Yeah.
You get freedom when you have a car. You can drive anywhere. You don't depend on other transports, other people. This is this is a benefit.
But I agree, that's a big benefit of having your own car. It's for the freedom to go when and where you want to, when you want to. Is the car expense a lot of your money? Do you spend a lot of money on this car?
Yes, I pay credit, and I have to pay for this car 2 years.
Mm-hmm. Do you have insurance?
Insurance.
What is insurance?
Yes.
You have to have insurance, right? You have credit payments. You have. Do you get pay? Is it just put gas in it, right? Benzene, gas.
Gas. Yeah.
Yeah, and then you gotta do maintenance work on it, right? Service the tires, stuff like this. Have you ever bought new tires?
Washing
it. Have you ever bought new tires? You know, tires?
New tires. I have original tires yet.
The original tires. Are they getting kind of slick? Do you need tires soon?
I changed tires at winter, for example.
You changed the tires already?
Every season.
You change the tires every season?
I change summer tires for...
Oh, summer to winter tires. I understand. You live in a cold climate, right?
Yes.
So that sounds like it's, you know, I've owned cars. I know this is, they can be pretty expensive to operate. Right?
Sorry?
They can be pretty expensive to operate.
Operate?
To own, because you got to spend money on them all the time, right?
Yes, it's expensive.
Yes, expensive. But it's a wonderful freedom, right?
Yeah.
Yes. You listen to this, Mary?
Sometimes when I don't drive car, I think that I paid too much money for this. And maybe I shouldn't buy this. But when I sit down in a car, I forgot about the sense, and I'm very happy.
Do you listen to this, Mary?
Yes, I listen.
Do you see the pros and cons of owning a car?
I don't know.
The pros and cons of owning a car, you get this wonderful freedom to go when you want to, where you want to, but at it costs a lot of money.
Yes, I understand, but I can do it.
You can do it.
Yes. Now I don't think about car. I don't think about that I can do it. So I may be better to learn.
Okay. So what do you think would be good things for young people to learn in university now? What subjects would be good things? Subjects for people in university now.
I think it's subject, main subject that they have. Maybe better will be to choose subject.
Well, like what kind of subjects would you think would be good for the universities to offer now for young people?
If people learn in philology, yes, it's some subject close for this specialty. But if people learn for mass or physical department, maybe it's better to learn this subject and don't learn something about language, about management, about something like that, because it's not necessary for the student.
Well, my question is, do you know anything, any new subjects that they don't offer now? Not like languages, not like physical fitness, not like old subjects. What do you think was something new that's new? You know what I'm saying?
I understand, but I don't know about new subjects.
Okay.
All subjects which I have is a subject now in university, and nothing new, and nothing new we have, and we don't have nothing new.
Do you think they should get something new?
I don't know. We have some computer some computer lesson about programming, so It can be something new, but we learn it.
Okay. Alexander, what do you think? Do you know of any subjects that the university needs to offer that they're not offering now?
Sorry, could you repeat?
Yes. Do you know of any subjects that the universities need to offer that they're not offering now?
I can't understand. Sorry.
Okay, do you understand subjects, right?
Subjects, yes.
Okay, what new subjects should you have at universities? New subjects.
What new subjects?
Yeah, they don't have now. Understand?
Yes, maybe a rule of safety, for example. It means judo, you know?
Judo? Like you mean like personal defense?
Yes, ability to save ourselves.
To protect ourselves, right?
To protect, yes, physical.
Physical protection. So if you knew some like martial arts, you could defend yourself as in a situation, right?
Yes.
Yes, I agree. They should at least offer that, right? Don't you think? I agree. That's a good idea to offer stuff like that. What about other subjects like, do they offer like how to run cities and run government like that? Do they offer classes in that kind of thing?
I didn't get.
Do you understand like to have a public office?
Public office?
Yeah, like a mayor or a prime minister or something like this. Do they teach that stuff in school?
What should they do?
Well, I mean, I think a lot of people go into politics and they don't know what they're talking about. They don't know what they're doing. They used to be a businessman. They used to be an advocate or something, and they don't understand how this works.
In every university, we should study law.
Law?
Yes, we should know. Every citizen should know law in country. And
okay, well, how about what should you at your university that you went to? What can they do differently to make it better? Do you understand?
No.
What could they do differently to make it better?
To make what better?
Your university.
Yes,
the education department, the education of the students.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know.
Could you offer any solutions, any ideas as to what they could do to maybe improve their university?
Maybe they should to improve their personal, like teachers, they should be more qualified.
You should have get better quality teachers?
They should have competition for choosing better teachers.
I agree. Mary, what do you think that universities should do to improve their universities?
I think they can show some video, like science video, because sometimes now I watch it and I understand something better than I understand it in school. So it can be very useful. And I think good to change health of teachers, because some teachers not really qualified, yes.
We need to have examination for teacher, yeah?
Yes.
Every year.
And alcohol test.
Alcohol test.
Not really, it's very important.
Okay, so what about school uniforms? Do you think they should have school uniforms or not? Mary?
I don't think that is important.
Why?
I don't know. It's like you must do it, and it's not necessary. For me, it's all time was very hard. I hate this form, and I want all time my teacher to force me go home and change.
Oh, because she comes to school without the uniform?
I hated it when I was in school, and I all time try to dress something else.
To break this rule, right? To break this rule.
Yes.
Yes. Alexander, did you have school uniforms?
Yes, when I was at school, I wore uniform, and we must, no,
Yes.
we had
Had
to.
to do this. Had to wear them, right? So, was it okay with this? Was you okay with this?
Yes, it was normal for me. Yeah.
Do I think that it's good for especially younger people because when you have different do people have different amounts of money. Some people are rich and some people are poor and they go to the same school and the rich people. Rich kids pick on the poor kids because of their bad clothes. What do you think?
Yes,
Mary, what do you think about that?
you know, children now have a phone, and it's a more better indicator of money than phone
Than
and
the
than
uniform.
clothes.
So they have another way to find out who's rich and who's poor and how to pick on them, right?
Yes, so it's not necessary
It's
to.
not necessary. Okay. Do you agree with this, Alexander, that all children have phones?
I don't know. When I was at school, nobody have some phones.
Me neither. Does everybody in your country go to Alexander? Does everybody in your country go to university?
Sorry, could you repeat the question?
Does everybody go to university in your city or your country?
Not everybody, because there are no enough places in university for all students who want to study in university.
Is it how do they determine who gets to go and who doesn't?
Sorry.
How do they decide who goes and who does not go?
Have they decided to go to university?
How do they decide who what children go to university and what children do not?
Oh,
Do they have a test?
they have test, yes, competition.
And did you two, I can't guess you passed this test, huh?
They should get enough marks, I think.
Okay. Okay. Mary, why are you studying English and French and all those other languages?
Why?
Why?
I don't know. I do it for a long time and I like learn English. I watch movie in English, read in English, and if I will not know, I can't do it. So it's more interesting. And maybe sometimes speak with people in English. It's interesting for me. Thomas, in America, all children go to university.
No.
Yes?
No, no,
No?
no, no,
It's
no.
difficult.
Difficult. Some are much harder than others. I mean, some are easier than others. There's a lot of different choices in America as far as schools, where they have also, I don't know what they call them here, but kind of trade schools. You learn some kind of a skill, like work on cars or drive a truck or like do women's hair. You know what I'm saying? Mary, you understand?
Not all.
Okay, do you understand they have like trade schools where they teach people how to drive a truck? You know, drive a truck?
Yes, I understand.
Do you know like work on cars, mechanic, car mechanic?
Yes, I understand.
These are specialized trades. These are just like trade schools. They're not for like, you know, you went to university, I went to university, but I taught you many different things about thinking, right? And and that sort of thing. It's not like that. I think I've heard of those in this country too, but I don't know what they're called. And a lot of people can't afford school in America. A lot of people who don't want to go to school just want to go get a job.
It's very expensive, yes, to learn in university, to study in university.
It can be, but they also offer a lot of options to help. They offer a lot of financing help, credit.
College, it's like university or not?
Like a small university, basically. It just mostly in America, as far as I can tell, it's about the size. If it's a big university, it's called a university. If it's a small one, it's called a college. There's not really any, that I know of, any real difference between these two names besides the size.
Okay.
Okay.
Difference from how the employer see on this difference, college and university. Is it better to finish university or college?
Yes, it's more it's got maybe a little more prestigious, but I don't know. It's more about the after you get out of there and you go to work. It's more about what you learned, you know, what you can put to work in a job. It's not really about after a couple of years what kind of paper you got says. It's more about what you can do for the company that you're trying to work for. That's all they really care about. I mean, you know, your education is more important than some, you know, unless you go into a real prestigious university like Harvard or something like this, that might mean getting you some doors, but normally not. I mean, it's just
famous university have special value, yeah, for them.
Yes, but on the other hand, those are also very expensive, and they're so hard to get into, even if you have to have a lot of money, they're still hard to get into because of the long list of people that want to get in these places. So that's that. I mean, you know, as far as that goes. But other than that, it's more about what you can use with this education, as far as I remember. So, Alexander, why are you studying English?
Oh, why?
Why? Why?
Big question.
Huh?
Because I like do it at first, and I want to travel, understand people, and I want to watch a movie in English, and what else, and we can get a better job if we know English.
Well, that's my question. Is, I mean, I would say, as hard as this learn languages, do you think you could make any money with this? I mean, you could improve your, you know, income. What could you do if you knew English well? What could you do to make more money, Alexander?
To work in an international company.
Doing what?
Anything at all. Sometimes you don't need in English, but a company but company says that you should know English working in our company. It's like
really? Just say that?
Yes.
Mary, okay, thank you. Mary, do you think you'll be able to turn your knowledge of these languages into money? You make money with this?
Maybe for somebody, yes. It's very important. You know, in my hometown, I have one company. Town has one company. It's called Procter & Gamble. Maybe no.
Procter & Gamble, I know.
Yes.
Yes, I know.
So open. And people who don't know English, they have a very small weight. But people who know English have a very, very, very good weight. they and who not only know English but they have education, they work engineer and something manager, a lot of profession, and they have vacation in different country. But people who didn't know, they their salary is maybe 2,000 hryvnia.
Do you know that if you know English well, you can get a lot of online jobs and do online work and get paid by doing just some online jobs, but you got to know English. You know about these jobs, Mary?
Yes, you have this job.
Oh, that job. No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about you could do. Yeah. I'm talking about jobs you could do for like small companies. You could do like little jobs for them and get paid like Western money, not like Ukraine money, but what Western salary. You understand?
Yes, I understand. I know. But I don't know. For me, it's not very important. I learn for myself, not for job.
Okay. Well, I mean, I just think that it would be if you had something you could use and you could make money with it, that'd be nice too. Especially if it's easy and from home. You know, that's always nice. Okay. Alexander, do you know anybody who was ever homeschooled, taught by their parents, then go to school?
Could you repeat, please?
Yes. Do you know anybody that was homeschooled, taught by their parents, did not go to school?
Oh, Mary.
Huh?
I didn't get a question.
Okay.
More slowly.
Do you know anybody that was homeschooled, taught by their parents? No school.
They don't go in school. They study at home.
Yeah. They don't go. Oh, I don't know. Is it impossible in Russia?
I don't know. You tell me.
When I was a pupil.
Yeah.
We didn't have this idea. All people, all child in Russia, in USSR, studied at school. Maybe some people who have had injuries, or not injuries.
Yes, like disabilities, right? Maybe somebody had injuries or disabilities, they couldn't go, physically could not go.
Yes, and teachers from school came to these people.
Really? Come to their house?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, that's interesting. I never heard about that. Okay, Mary, tell me about what about cheating in your university and your school. Do people cheat a lot?
Yes, of course.
Yes, of course. What do you mean, of course?
Because all people do it.
All people don't do this.
Yes.
Maybe in your country, all people do this, but not in all places. Is this bad for education? I mean, you don't have to learn, do you? You just have to cheat. You don't have to learn.
I think it happened because it's the easiest way to show the good result.
I understand, but it actually kind of waters down your experience. You know, when you leave school, you don't know anything, right? Maybe the one guy that studied knows, and the rest of the people cheated.
You know, as you say, the paper is not important, but if you have maybe not very interesting subject, you can cheat a lot and show the results which they want, teachers want, and to solve the problem.
I don't know. I understand. Especially if it's a something that you don't want to know anyways, right? You just want to get through it. But you need a good grade. So it's important for the grade. You guys, it's called marks, right? It's important for the.
If you haven't time, maybe it helps.
Yeah, I understand. Students here are very busy. Is that Alexander, when you was in school, was you very busy?
At school?
Yeah, were you very busy in school? Were you in your university, excuse me, university?
University? No, I studied in not every day as usually students study. We studied. We got tasks from university and studied home. And after some months, we came to the university and gave examens.
Yes, I understand. So, but I never got your opinion on cheating. What do you think about cheating, Alexander?
Cheating answer.
Cheating. You know, cheating?
To be honest, we should cheat him because it was difficult to study everything for us. Yes, we use different way to cheat.
Do you think that they should change the way they do the schools, or they think that, you know, why do they make you take all this stuff? It makes me to just do have taken less classes instead of have you do so much stuff. Which would be better, you think? Do you think they should change the classes, Alexander?
Changed.
Yeah, make you do less.
Make it less.
Instead of doing more, do less. Do you understand?
Yes. No, I didn't.
No.
No.
Mary, did you take a lot of stupid classes in university?
I think yes, I have some stupid classes in university.
Do you think they should drop those classes? Stop people taking those classes?
Yes, I think. Thomas, do you never cheat in?
Do I never cheat?
Yes.
If I were at university, if you got caught cheating, they would throw you out of the school. So no, I didn't cheat. You understand?
Yes, I understand, but I think it's not possible because in our country all time children cheating in university, in school.
I understand. I taught schools here. They think it's like a group project. You know, they test and they all try to help each other. It's like, whoa, I want to see individual results, not the other group set test. But no, I was teaching, you know, give a test in English class, and no, they're all helping each other. You know, it's like, what? You know, you got good students, you got bad students, you need to help the bad students. You don't need to just give them the answers and tell them to go on. They'll never learn English that way, right? Isn't that true, Mary?
Can you repeat question?
Yes. When I taught English classes. I have English classes here sometimes, but then I give tests, and people think it's a group answers. They try to help each other with the answers. Do you understand?
Yes, I understand.
But it's not right because I'm going to try to find out who is the best, you know, people that are having trouble with these tests, right? So I can help them more instead of somebody just giving them the answer.
Yes, you know, if in our country, if you fail in exam, you can not get money because we have some students have money in university.
Yes.
So it's very important for students to have a good mark. So I think it's one way why they didn't. I don't know about American students. They have some money for university.
Okay, well, if you get really good grades, they will give you a scholarship, which means like give you money to go to school. And if you don't get good grades, you're right, they'll stop the scholarship, they'll stop the money. So it's important for you to get good grades. But I think that the difference is over the years, American universities have improved their way they do things, and a lot of these schools here or Soviet systems don't change. They stay the same. I mean, I live in Nikolaev. They have a shipbuilding university. They teach people how to build ships. There's no, they haven't built ships here for a long time. They learn how to build ships here, and then they go to some other country and build ships because there's no jobs here for that. And other examples of this, where they don't make changes to make things improve the education. Do you understand?
Yes, I understand. Yes, I think it's a bad situation in our country because it's really nothing changed in our university, and we have the same problem each every year, and with students and with teachers. But you know, maybe some information it's really doesn't necessary. So why
isn't necessary?
Isn't necessary?
Is it necessary?
Is it necessary? So sometimes they do it.
Okay. Alexander, do you still live in the same town as your university?
In the same town?
City. Do you live in the same city as your university?
No, I studied it in another city. Yes, I.
You studied in another city. Okay. Do you ever go back and visit that city?
When I studied, I should visit.
No. Now, have you recently? Recently?
No,
have you recently went back to that city and visited it? And visited maybe friends you had there?
No, I don't go there because our students in the group came to this university from a different part of Russia, and we don't met, but sometime we will have agreement and we'll meet.
Reunion, they call those things, reunions. Do you stay in touch with anybody? Do you know still to talk to, or you know, stay in touch with anybody you went to university with?
Sorry.
Alexander, do you know anybody now that you went to the university with?
Do I know anybody who I studied with?
Yeah, now.
We just communicate in social networks.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Basically, if they're a long ways away, you have to, right? Yeah, so you're social, Facebook or whatever. VK, right?
Yes.
So you, many of your schoolmates you stay in contact with?
Not many, maybe.
A few. Okay. Mary, do you stay in contact with anybody you went to university with?
Yes, it's my boyfriend.
It's your boyfriend?
Yes, we study in one group and live together after university.
After university, moved in together. That's a benefit of university, right?
Yes,
find a boyfriend. Expensive way to find a boyfriend, but that is way. And do you stay in contact with many other people through like Facebook or VK?
Not a few people, yes. With few people I speak sometimes.
Okay. Let's see here. Do you think that the buildings that they have in universities make a big difference? Do you have a nice building? Would it make a better school? Alexander, do you think they have better facilities? Would it be like a better gym? Like you're talking about working out and stuff. They have better facilities? Would they be a better education?
Repeat, please.
Yes, if they had a better, like you said, you like to exercise and work out. If they had a better workout place, better gymnasium, better, what do you call it, gymnasium, something else. Would they have a better education?
I didn't get what the question is.
If they had better buildings and better stuff at the university, would it be better?
Should they do something better?
If they had better facilities, if they had better buildings and schools and classrooms and stuff, would education be better?
I don't know, maybe. Maybe
Okay.
if
Okay.
students will sorry, if they will feel better in good buildings, maybe, I don't know.
Okay. Thank you for coming. It's 10 o'clock now, and have a good week. We'll be back here tomorrow, next Monday at 9 o'clock. Talk about charity, and we'll see what we can talk about then. Thank you for coming to our class here tonight, and I'll see you back here again next Monday. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Bye
Goodbye.
bye. Thank you for listening. Goodbye.
Bye
Да.
Что вы, Александр, устали?
Да, вспотел.
Да, вообще плохо слышно. Ну как, тихо.
Кого слышно плохо? Меня?
Да, как-то тише микрофон стал.
Странно. Может, микрофон далеко?
Надо, наверное, поближе, потому что так как-то...
Да прямо к рту прямо поднес. Я это, честно говоря, вот его, когда слушаю, тоже... Я уж думал, где же громкость прибавить-то? Что-то как-то тихо слышно.
Может быть, надо было говорить, а может он тогда понять, а когда видно, что посильнее кричит.
Может быть, Hangout что-то как-то слабо громкость дает, потому что везде остальные места там хорошо слышно.
Да.
А вот здесь я максимально, я в наушниках прибавляю максимально, и кое-как слышно.
Не знаю, может поменялась какая-то настройка, надо будет глянуть, как бы я так не смотрел. Они же там любят такое делать.
И что интересно, вот
фантазия какая-нибудь там у этих разработчиков.
Ясно. Ну, это, конечно, преподаватель. Если научиться его понимать, то потом всех остальных будешь понимать.
Да, тарахтит иногда быстро, конечно, очень.
Как-то прям, не знаю, как это так.
Это такой, как тоже называется разговорная речь реально, как бы как на улице, грубо говоря.
А он вообще это откуда он?
А он же там говорил как-то вот, что откуда-то там какая-то и вроде бы из северной части. Я что-то сейчас забыл уже, как бы Америки, как там. Надо будет спросить в следующий раз. Ну, сейчас он там на Украине, но вот где-то там вроде бы северная часть Америки.
Ага.
Когда-то он рассказывал, что какой город, черт возьми. Преподавателей новых там начал уже ставить потихоньку. Тестировали, да. Скоро видели, не?
Нет, еще интересно.
Сейчас я поставил там какую-то девушку. Посмотрим. Четверг, пятница пока.
Ну, ладно. До свидания.
Давайте, Александр, планируйте протест.
Вы что-то там сегодня это, отдыхали, да, смотрю?
А что-то не успел чуть-чуть. Там начали сидеть, там и пропустил все, что можно.
Ну ладно.
Да, на связи, все, пока.